So Meta might have just introduced the future of large language models. Well, I guess after this video, you won't be calling them large language models anymore. This is what we call large concept models, language modeling in sentence representation space. Basically, it states that large language models, LLMs, aren't exactly the best thing to use. And in this new paper by Meta, they detail large concept models. This is something a little bit different from LLMs, and it's really cool when you realize what it is tackling. We all know what LLMs are, but if you know how they work, you'll understand that they function through the process of tokenization. These systems work by predicting the next word via the token, so you can essentially think of them as advanced autocomplete. Although some researchers might hate this analogy, it is how the process works. I've used the GPT-4 tokenizer visualizer to show what the characters actually look like to the LLM system. This explains the big debate around why LLM models failed to correctly answer the famous question, how many R's are in strawberry? There are 3 R's, but the models often see strawberry as one entire token, leading to confusion. This issue was highlighted by another AI researcher who expressed confidence that tokenization might soon become obsolete. He argued that humans don't think in tokens. Tokens are hard-coded abstractions in LLMs that lead to weird behavior. For instance, LLMs can solve PhD-level math problems but struggle with simple questions like, is 9.9 bigger than 9.11? According to this researcher, Meta is now shifting from LLMs to large context or large concept models, which change next token prediction to next concept prediction. In these models, a concept is treated as a sentence representing an abstract idea or action. Despite the undeniable success of LLMs, they miss a crucial characteristic of human intelligence: explicit reasoning and planning at multiple levels of abstraction. Humans don't operate at the word level only. We solve complex tasks or compose long documents by planning at a higher level first, such as outlining, and then iteratively adding details. While some argue that LLMs implicitly learn hierarchical representation, Meta suggests that models with an explicit hierarchical architecture are better suited for creating coherent long-form output. This could explain why certain models reason better than others. Perhaps they already employ this architecture. For example, imagine a researcher giving a 15-minute presentation. They don't typically prepare detailed speeches by writing every single word. Instead, they outline higher-level ideas to communicate, often using brief points on a PowerPoint slide. If they deliver the same talk multiple times, the words spoken might differ, even in different languages, but the abstract ideas remain the same. This hierarchical approach is also evident in how humans process large documents. They remember which parts to search for relevant information and refine their understanding iteratively. Meta's research introduces a novel architecture where language is processed in layers. The bottom layer, the concept encoder, converts regular words into complete ideas or concepts. The middle layer, the large concept model, processes and understands these concepts, focusing on their meaning rather than specific words. The top layer, the concept decoder, transforms processed concepts back into regular language that humans can read. This process resembles translating a story written in one language into universal symbols, processing the ideas, and then converting them back into another language. Interestingly, this large concept model architecture mirrors the JEPA approach pioneered by Yann LeCun at Meta AI. This approach predicts the representation of the next observation in an embedding space, aiming to mimic how humans learn. The results are promising.
Today, machines require thousands of examples and hours of training to learn a single concept. The goal of JEPAs, which means joint embedding predictive architectures, is to create highly intelligent machines that can learn as efficiently as humans. VJEPA is pre-trained on video data, allowing it to efficiently learn concepts about the physical world, similar to how a baby learns by observing its parents. It's able to learn new concepts and solve new tasks using only a few examples without full fine-tuning. VJEPA is a non-generative model that learns by predicting missing or masked parts of a video in an abstract representation space. Unlike generative approaches that try and fill in every missing pixel, VJEPA has the flexibility to discard irrelevant information, which leads to more efficient training. To allow our fellow researchers to build upon this work, we're publicly releasing VJEPA. We believe this work is another important step in the journey towards AI that's able to understand the world, plan, reason, predict, and accomplish complex tasks.
large concept models generate coherent and meaningful expansions, avoid excessive repetition, and follow instructions better than LLMs like Llama 3.1a. They also produce controlled length expansions more effectively. Overall, tokenization has long been a pain point for LLMs. Small issues, like misinterpreting how many R's are in strawberry, can be frustrating when evaluating the capabilities of these otherwise smart models. Meta's work might signal the future of LLMs or even a hybrid architecture. It's exciting to see Meta pioneering such innovative research. Let me know what you think about this development. Do you see it as the future of LLMs, or is something else on the horizon? Whatever the case, Meta's progress is worth watching, and I hope you enjoyed this deep dive. See you in the next one.